So, have you ever been to a strip club? You've never been to a strip club? Why? Really? Not even for a bachelor party?
I've never been there.
Would you ever consider stripping if, like, somebody came to you and was like, you know what, I'm going to give you 5,000 rand, strip for us?
I'm not sure. I think 5,000 is a bit low.
Can you strip for us? Yo, I don't like the thing, but then who am I to judge?
Would you ever consider going to a strip club?
Yeah, I would. I wouldn't mind.
Those type of clubs, then they are for certain people. Those then we are not having we are not having a vision with their life.
So it's easy to say shake what your mama gave you, but it's another thing to know how to shake it, when to shake it, what must happen when you shake it, you know, who's around when you shake it. But you know what? We have Kirsty Becker here from iPole Dance Studios to help us figure all of that out. Like, girl. First of all, let me just say, I'm already exhausted.
Well done.
From what you just showed us. Like,
you
people
did amazing.
Don't know how much work this is, you know, like actually, you know, holding yourself up and, yeah, and all of that. What are the misconceptions about, you know, pole dancing?
I think one of the biggest misconceptions is that people think that it's just like a pretty sport and you can just throw your body around, look sexy. But I think it takes a lot more than that. You know, it takes strength and it takes courage, and it's kind of scary sometimes. You have to trust yourself, and that takes a lot out of a person. Pole dancing activates almost every muscle in the body. I think the only it still activates the jaw because you're just giggling so much, you know. But like, it really does. Pole dancing, you need a lot of upper body strength to hold yourself up, and you need a lot of thigh strength and butt.
The glutes. What is the difference between like stripping and pole dancing?
So I think the biggest difference, I mean, apart from the fact that it's got to do with money. Like, pole dancing, you're paying for classes, and stripping, you're getting paid to dance.
Yeah.
So I think there's a big difference in that, but I think mainly it's the style of dancing. As you saw tonight, we were fully clothed and
exactly
able to do so much, and so much sexy stuff, fully clothed.
Right.
We don't have to show our bodies off,
and take off our clothes.
I mean, we can save that for the bedroom, you know? Whereas the stripping side, it is more of more taking off of the clothes,
right.
But also we've had a few strippers come in and they found it quite challenging. You know?
Really?
Yeah, because stripping, it's like we said, it's more sexy and it's more simple. Whereas pole dancing, we really start to activate elements that require strength,
right,
you know, and require flexibility. Thank you so much for coming to us today.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was awesome. Well done.
Checking you guys back at the studio, Joe.